Well, what a stunning property in Golden Grove in Spring Hill. Please get out there and have a look at it. It's just gorgeous. Now, if you're just joining me today, I have the South Australian President of the Property Council of Australia, Justin Hazel, with me. Welcome back, Justin.
Thanks, Mandy.
One of the biggest things that's happened in Adelaide in the last week would be the redevelopment of Adelaide Oval. Mm. How do you see that progressing? I think it's a great thing for the town.
Oh, look, I think it's absolutely amazing. And I'm to be perfectly honest, I'm surprised that it got up. Everyone was saying that it wasn't going to get approved by the SACA members, but I think to get 80%, in excess of 80% of the vote, just really shows you how much South Australia is dying for this to occur. And I think that Minister Conlon's excitement when he made the announcement yesterday just reinforces how good it's going to be for this state and how good it's going to be for Adelaide.
Yeah, I think, do you agree that it's certainly going to push the growth? We're a small city and we need that growth pattern.
Oh, look, absolutely. I think that Adelaide Oval will not be considered in isolation either. I think that there's a broader plan which involves the regeneration of the riverbank precinct on the southern side of the Torrens, and I think that Adelaide Oval and the riverbank precinct revitalisation will act as a massive catalyst for future growth in the CBD, and they'll continue to reinforce the relevance of Adelaide in South Australia's hierarchy. Mm. So fantastic for the state.
Absolutely. We heard earlier with Cameron Cusher that Adelaide is the most affordable mainland state and city to live in. Mm-hmm. Do you see with this infrastructure and the growth that it's going to stay that way, or will it push it up to be more sitting in line with the eastern seaboard?
Look, I think Adelaide's going to remain affordable for quite some years. I think there's also investigations that are occurring towards introducing alternative forms of construction or alternative construction techniques, including drop-top housing and modular pre-packed flat housing.
Could you just explain, because I had to ask you before, drop-pack housing,
What
actually is that?
Drop-top housing is essentially a prefabricated housing module which is craned in on site, stacked up on top of each other, and it essentially forms a medium density or high density product. It's not going to be suitable for everyone, but there's certainly segments of the marketplace, such as student accommodation, etc., where it's going to be a highly relevant alternative.
Mm-hmm. Do you see that expanding out to the suburbs, that type of living, or do you see it mainly within the city limits, basically?
Look, I think it can expand out to some suburban locations. It could potentially expand to locations that have got existing strong student catchments, places like Mawson Lakes, for example. Or if there's ongoing development into that product type so that it becomes more suited to a general type of purchaser, then there's no reason that it can't be expanded into all of the infill regions.
I think we've got some exciting time ahead, Justin, and thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks very much, Mandy.
Now let's look at some hot properties. Well, that's all we have time for today. Join us again on Friday at 12 midday for a fireside chat and learn everything about real estate. And watch TOOP TV next week for a look at some beautiful properties, including a gorgeous farm in Oakbank. So we'll see you next Wednesday at 1 p.m. on TOOP TV.